Here at home, the newly elected Virginia Attorney General says the state's ban on gay marriage is unconstitutional. Mark Herring not only said he will no longer defend it in federal lawsuits, he even joined a suit challenging the ban. In a brief filed in federal court today, Herring says marriage is a fundamental right and that the measure is discriminatory. Virginia voters approved the gay marriage ban back in 2006. And for more on this, we turn now to Peter Sprigg. He is the senior fellow for policy studies at the Family Research Council. Peter, if an attorney general decides a law of a state is unconstitutional, can they just refuse to uphold that law as Attorney General Herring is doing?
Well, it seems a violation of one of their most fundamental responsibilities of an attorney general, which is to defend the law, and in this case, the Constitution of their own state against a court challenge. Attorney General Herring is claiming that he's concluded that the Virginia constitutional amendment violates the U.S. Constitution. But in light of the fact that there's nothing about same-sex marriage or sexual orientation found in the text of the U.S. Constitution, that's really not a decision for him to make. It's really shocking that one of his first acts, just literally days after taking office and swearing an oath to uphold the Virginia state constitution, one of his first acts would be to attack it in court.
Well, is this a new strategy, or have attorneys general historically used this technique to get rid of new laws, like in this case?
Well, it's not completely without precedent. The attorney general does have an obligation to make an evaluation about the constitutionality of laws. But because of his position and his role in defending his state's laws in court, the bias or the presumption should be in favor of treating your own state's laws as constitutional unless they are in direct conflict with an existing Supreme Court precedent, which in this case is not the case because the United States Supreme Court has not ruled on the constitutionality of state laws defining marriage as the union of one man and one woman.
Peter, how can supporters of traditional marriage fight this at the state level?
Well, this situation actually illustrates the importance of elections. Elections have consequences. Attorney General Herring was elected by a margin of less than 1,000 votes, just a few hundred votes out of millions cast across the Commonwealth of Virginia. It's very important to be involved in the political process because who holds these offices makes a great deal of difference.
All right. Peter Sprigg with the Family Research Council. Thank you for your time and your insights, sir.
Thank you.